It happens. So. So, always forward, never backward, edition 2014. Nord News Show. Great bass. Towards the sunset.
Herzlich willkommen zur FNOT News Show 2014.
Heartfelt welcome to the FNOT News Show of 2014. Nice that you're all here again. We'll start with news from sport news. So we always try to discover trends and point them out. And one trend that we saw this year was that martial arts was becoming an everyday common sport, at least in politics. So we tried to find role models. This is pole fighting. And then we have another pole fight here, and then things got pretty tough. Image of Chancellor Merkel there. And since we always have this scientific research mission, we are wondering what techniques are actually being used. We all know Bruce Lee and the weaponless martial arts, and well, this guy, he seems to have had a lot of knowledge. John Kerry, too, seems to tend that way. And they all seem to be working on the same kind of moves. And we've tried to find which movement that actually is. And then we looked at the Grandmaster and noticed that it can't be that difficult, because even... And then Fefe actually found what the technique is called. After a long amount of research, it's called Monkey Steals the Peach. And for those that can't really imagine, we have... Goodness me. Just so that you... So next time you see a politician gesturing, you know what they actually mean. Politicians, of course, are a role model for the youth. Yes, for example, this year we had this impressive case where two teenagers managed, a 14-year-old and a 13-year-old, managed to hurt five police people, get three of them into hospital. And yet again, we thought, where did they actually get this from? Do they watch too much TV? It turns out it's actually politicians. Yet again, they have been watching Ukrainian TV. The parliament there is relatively full with scenes of violence. We've always said that politics is a profession that tends towards criminality. And of course, it's not just in reality where you find violence, but in books and stories, old and new, in the fantasy literature, of course. And we noticed this when we were researching Ukraine, because at the beginning of this year, there were a few perils that we'd like to point out. For example, D&D is a very popular thing in the Ukraine. We see a cleric here, and not just from known mainstream deities. There are clerics in the Ukraine, but also of less well, not just clerics, but what do they have those? Why do you have those in the party? The undead, for example. There is a certain kind of genre in literature for that. And here you see an undercover police person who was uncovered by demonstrators and colleagues rescuing him. You see this woman from the demonstrators who tried giving another kick to his tools, a clear role model here, and more D&D issues here. There were fighters as well. And video games too are popular, we found. This is a postmodern role model, more than postmodern than D&D. The traffic signs, something you see a lot in video games. We took one example, Fallout, but there are other games. We found another nice example. Who will guess it? And recent cinema movie influences are clearly there, at least for the performance on TV, Schwarzenegger's End of Days. And not just in Ukraine can you see cinema influences. We found a picture of Catalonia in Spain, the region in Spain, a shotgun
with a muffler.
Muffler, thank you. And if you're into martial arts and not untrained, but try to use it, you have to take care. There's a certain danger of getting hurt. Which was fairly obvious. And this man actually had his $120,000 pension for hurting himself by beating, punching up demonstrators. This is the actual cop, not a setup. And violence in politics seems to be quite common in other countries too. Here we have the advisor for President Erdogan in Turkey, who kicks a demonstrator, the guy in the suit, and this advisor was then written, he got sick leave for having hurt his foot, and which gets us to a complex that we had to deal with quite a lot. There's a number of things that are connected to advisors. The advisor apocalypse, it says on the slide. We'll start with an old, well-known person whom we have given lots of credit to, German Railways. This is the head of the Chancery, Pofalla, in main post in politics, becoming a person in the board of German Railways, and news of those things can actually have large effects even before the actual act, the change of position took place. German Railways did not have a good year. ICE turns the wrong way in Frankfurt was a headline. You see Pofalla's influence here. Pofalla much maligned for the way he treated the NSA scandal. Another well-known person, Hartmut Medorn, former CEO of German Railways, now responsible for the fantastic, miserable failure of the new airport in Berlin. And he actually hired advisors too from PricewaterhouseCoopers. And these advisors then had to go because somehow they had no idea what they were talking about. Did they actually find something? The airport's opening had to be postponed because just before the intended opening, huge flaws in the building site were discovered. So they tried to find out what actually went wrong, and the latest advisors what went wrong with them. And the press wasn't that enthusiastic anymore about the whole story. And then suddenly something nice happened. Hartmut Medan was fed up, and he left the post. And then another astonishing thing happened. KPMG had to make savings within themselves. Bonuses were cut, and even heating was turned off, which is what the newspaper article says here. Maybe they have a fire protection problem too, like the prospective Berlin airport, but never worry. What are consultancies for if not in crisis, times of crisis, and here you are with the German army. Now, this German army thing actually gives me a bit of hope, because not just KPMG is now looking at the misery at the German army. We have a state secretary that has a past with McKinsey, so we have a real hope for peace and the decommissioning of arms, because there's not a lot that's left as soon as McKinsey has stopped working for anyone. So, actually, it started quite quickly. Newspaper headlines about things that went wrong, arms that were stolen. So the sentence I marked down there will highlight. The news report says that your fighter is so broken that we can't really fly with it. But, well, the sentence is not to worry, we weren't really going to fly with it anyway, not a lot. And those that are not focused on the Eurofighter anymore, it used to be called the Hunter 90, and it was supposed to be flying in the 90s at some point. So they had to say, okay, well, if you have problems in Kenya in your Ebola mission, we'll have to leave you there. We have nothing to fly you back. And we have this this thing here, the internet found that there was this meeting of heads of government. And if you look closely, they seem to be looking at the sky, looking at some planes. Ah. Now the headline says, all heads of government that have airplanes in the air look up. Okay, I like these things. You can use the nuclear option and force the German army to introduce SAP software. That would really be the finishing of them. Maybe they will get this idea. And as far as I know, they are trying this. Hercules have had SAP problems, I think. So the German army is fairly safely written off by now. What did I say? Structurally unable to unable for warfare.
The next
advisory company that had a certain role to play was CSC this year. They had this little data protection problem at the Schengen information system, which is the linking of police institutions in European countries and other countries in the Schengen area. And there was an attack where the one or other record was stolen, and records from Germany were affected in the high six-digit numbers. But it was said, don't worry, this is all coded. Does that mean encryption? No. Not really encryption. It's, well, there's a number where you see this police movies, you have a number for a coding for crimes or things like that. So who is actually capable enough to start working at CC? Who could that have been? And it turns out this year that the Pirate Bay founder was given a sentence for leaking data from CSC,
and one
medium or other actually in small print did say that this was about Schengen region databases, which means that it must have been the same case. And those that can't really figure out what CSC is, this is one of the largest contractors of the NSA, and they actually run the IT there, or large parts of it, and this groundbreaker program, for example. And they are heavily involved to running large conferences like the climate summits, which the NSA then spied upon, and where they thought they were quite successful in spying. And well, you then think CSC, well, maybe we shouldn't really do anything with that anymore. And then it turns out our government in Germany had a huge bucket of commissions for them. State police office, new contracts from Bavaria, and CSE then promised that they wouldn't pass on any data to NSA, of course, with these contracts.
Ich fühle mich gleich viel besser.
I feel much better now.
Aber es gibt but
there is hope. They are involved in Hercules as well, which of course for the NSA as a supplier is quite interesting. But well, this is the German army. So decommissioning of arms is not under threat, and the whole sequence would not be complete without a well-known friend, T-Systems, the IT arm of Deutsche Telekom, the IT services arm. There were some problems with meeting deadlines in the contract with the state of Lower Saxony, which led to the whole thing taking a bit longer, and they having to run XP a bit longer. You see the new screen background there for XP.
I think
we've gone through all the companies, or is there another? Oh, there's actually a few more. Boston Consulting, because they have had a really tough case. The German Liberal Party, FDP, who went out of parliament in the last general elections, they have taken a real nosedive.
No.
Oh, dear.
Also bisher sind die Erfolge des
until now,
eher noch so ein bisschen
the success of that consultancy project
finden,
is a bit hard to determine. It's, they come under others in election statistics now. And but well, this might change.
Noch jemand, der sozusagen
another one that
well,
when you're talking politicians and consultancy companies, politicians can be good advisors, of course. And Roland Koch, former state premier of the state of Hesse, conservative right-wing, who suggested that you could throw stones on solar panels because with all the state grants they get, this is actually counterproductive and they should be destroyed to help the economy. And he was then the head of Bilfinger Berger, a building conglomerate actually,
and
he immediately started. As soon as Roland Koch started there, they wondered, well, this building business, this was the share value, because he said that building is actually, well, we'll move to services, we don't like building anymore. And that didn't go so well, and there were a few incidents concerning corruption, millions of penalties in the US, and there was a profit warning, the third one actually, and the value of the probably is it.
Yeah, where we're gerade bei der Politik sind.
And speaking of politics, Sebastian Edati was accused of downloading child pornography in the parliament, in the Bundestag, and we made it into a photo story here.
Der nun nicht so gänzlich schadensfrei
he was a member of the committee investigating the right-wing terrorists. The NSU had committed a chain of murders.
Dienststellen kam,
and
dass er halt
he was suspected of downloading child pornography or child abuse images, and the question was, who warned him from his party, the Social Democrats, because he took off, resigned from Parliament, lost his laptop just in time before the investigation started, and there was a large hithering and throwing and pulled out all the works, investigated him, and people, it turned out, had been sitting on the files for a long time, and they had a case themselves in the house. There was an official in the Federal Criminal Police Office himself, Case D, as it was called, and this was then extracted from the data, and there was an oral information. And within a few days, the whole thing was resolved.
And
Mr. Edati had to leave over this, and something had to be strange there, because isn't there someone who was intensely involved, Mr. Zierke, head of the Federal Criminal Police Office? Why was he in office for such a long time? And we found this nice quote on the Canadian customer list. There could be a few more surprises, says the chief of the Federal Criminal Police Office, which is probably why he was able to hold himself there. And this picture as an illustration would serve us nicely, I guess.
Ja, wir haben als nächstes eine neue Kategorie.
The next thing that we have is a new category.
Mit einem neuen Begriff,
first time this year.
Nämlich der Merkel-Effekt.
The Merkel-Effekt.
Und der Merkel-Effekt.
The Merkel-Effekt. Das ist really
a. Edward Snowden definiert.
Well, Edward Snowden sort of defined that.
Einige Menschen sind gleicher als andere.
Some people are more equal than others.
Übrigens unten links auch Frau Merkel. Kann sich noch
jemand an das picture in the lower left corner, that's also Mrs. Merkel. Can anyone remember that type of phone that she's using? Did anyone have that? Well, anyway, the Merkel effect is when someone suddenly gets angry as soon as he realizes that he himself is a victim. Oh, we found a number of those. For example, Mr. Gauck, the German federal president,
and,
apparently people who worked for the German intelligence agency had been spying on him, and he was very angry about that. He gave an interview in a morning TV show and made some gestures with his finger who were not exactly presidential. But that didn't stop him from, well, raising the salaries of the members of the parliament, so we decided to have a closer look at him. And one thing that he did is in January at a security conference in Munich, he held a speech.
Und da hat er einen schönen Begriff, nämlich
and
die elektronische Gefahrenabwehr.
Und used a nice term, er meinte die NSA, the electronic Ziel hinaus defense.
Damit meint er den NSA
was a little bit over the top, and what he was referring to was the NSA surveillance scandal, of course. And we found this nice comparison in the web about what he said about Stauffenberg. Said we must be courageous and
have to
stand up for our values. And about Edward Snowden, he said he has no understanding for the things that he did. So that's actually the guy that we have for president.
Beim nächsten Fall, also ich habe immer versucht,
case that we have, I always try to find some before and after pictures. Next case, it's a little tricky to find an after picture because he always has this stupid look when he's looking at the camera. Well, I have one, but, well, it's not really, well. Well, he complained at President Obama because he doesn't actually like companies collecting data, at least not if this company is the NSA. And, of course, there was all this talking about the no-spy agreement, and the German intelligence agency was actually
also über das europäische No-Spy-Abkommen, wir haben den Chef vom BND und vom Verfassungsschutz.
The head of the German intelligence agency and was negotiating with the US and he said that the US has been lying to us.
Also ein Geheimdienst ist davon überrascht, dass ein anderer Geheimdienst.
So actually what we had here, one intelligence agency was disappointed that another intelligence agency was actually lying to them.
Ja.
Okay, I'm going to show it again. Which is, of course, a scene from a very famous French movie with Louis de Funès.
Auch sehr überrascht war die CDU, als sie feststellte,
the Christian Democratic Union was also very surprised when they found out that there was data retention in the German Bundestag. We always tend to say that doing surveillance about politicians, that's something good. I mean, we never realized that they would actually follow through with this. So the fact that the Christian Democrats were surprised too, that I can kind of understand why that was.
Ja, auch schockiert und entsetzt.
And we were also shocked. The US was shocked when they found out that China was engaging in economical espionage.
Und die NSA den Huawei-Konzern gehackt hat.
And the NSA had been hacking into the Huawei company. It was a little embarrassing for them that these two messages made news close to each other. John McCain was also shocked.
Und er ist zu einer spannenden Einsicht gekommen.
And he came to a realization that we want to share with you. He thought that the way the Germans acted in this crisis was a little stupid. And he said, you get the impression that in Berlin, big companies are making politics.
Doch.
Doch. So of course what these guys are saying is no, but yes, oh.
Ja, wir haben nur zweimal eingebaut. Das
well,
uns leid
we actually only had this little movie clip twice. We didn't know that you would like it so much, but let's do it one more time.
Doch. Oh. That's great. Nein.
Doch.
Oh.
Ja. Also,
well,
auch der US-Außenminister hat dieses Jahr mit Empörung reagiert.
The foreign minister of the US was also a little angry when he saw that Russia was behaving like a 19th century country and simply invading other countries with made up reasons.
Wo gibt's denn sowas?
Kam irgendwie
Who
nie vor
does that? I've never seen anything like it
ja, auch
in the past decade.
But,
we also have some nice effects here. We, the Social Democrats, they were also shocked when they realized that the NSA has been spying on former Chancellor Schröder as well. They didn't have a problem with it when they were just spying on Merkel.
Tja.
And apparently Minister Maas said,
einige Meldungen dieses Jahr
spying on the phones of chancellors is not helping the defense against the terrorism.
Ich habe da mal was vorbereitet.
I've prepared a little something here. And the subtitle says, a party of traitors.
Jetzt spielt er nicht, ich krieg nicht diese.
Apparently the video is not playing.
Mann! Machen wir nochmal. Scheiße. Die Technik. Einen haben wir noch.
Okay, one more try.
Ich weiß nicht, warum er nicht spielt.
I have no idea why it's not playing.
Wir haben das fünfmal getestet.
We tested it five times. It always worked, but now it's not.
Reboot tut gut.
All right, let's try a reboot here.
Ja. Ist schon laut. Achso, ist sie hier?
I've turned up the volume already.
Es gibt da so einen Spruch von den alten Kommunisten.
There is an old saying that the communists had. They were discrediting their friends in 1918. Of course, the political environment today is different, but the saying still fits into today. Who has betrayed us? The Social Democrats. Who betrayed us? Who betrayed us? Who has sold us? Who betrayed us? The Social Democrats. They betrayed us. And they also sold us out.
Ja, schade, dass es komplett nicht klappt, aber.
Sorry, it didn't really work, but.
Vorführeffekt.
Aber ja, die SPD hat
sich live on stage, but the Social Democrats, they didn't really.
Also der NSA-Untersuchungsausschuss ist zum Beispiel deswegen nicht zustande gekommen über lange Zeit, weil die SPD.
The Inquiry Board about the NSA affair.
Und ein besonderer Freund ist natürlich der SPD-Fraktionschef Oppermann, der.
Couldn't really get any work done because, for example, the head of the Social Democrat fractions declined
aus der Atlantikbrücke. Das nämlich der
US-Botschafter intelligence agency were actually being audited, and that is of course because he has good relations to the other side of the Atlantic Ocean. So this is what's called the Atlantic Bridge, and we have it here.
Was kann da schon schief gehen?
What can possibly go wrong?
Ja, ein besonderes Freundesgeschenk sind natürlich immer Länder, die eine Vorratsdatenspeicherung haben, auf die man sich dann beziehen kann.
Is when there are countries that have data retention and you can refer to them. So for example, Mr. Gabriel referred to Norway and the data retention laws that they have.
And he
referred to Mr. Breivik being caught because of the data retention laws. But the problem was that when Breivik committed his crimes, that they did not have these laws yet. And there was a nice verdict of the European, court,
woraufhin so auch gewisse Aussagen der Politiker relativiert werden mussten,
that basically rendered all these data retention laws invalid, and the reaction was that they actually renamed these laws.
Wer kann da was dagegen haben? Nicht angemessen.
And that's all they did. So just changing the name and the problem is solved, apparently.
Auch angemessen finden natürlich irgendwie die SPD dann den Unterbindungsgewahrsam sogar gegen den Rat ihrer Experten. Also es ging um einen Berliner Vorfall, und zwar der konservative
Senator Hinkel wollte gerne... There's actually another thing where the German police is able to take someone into custody for a certain period of time, and they wanted to make that period of time longer to 4 days, and...
natürlich irgendwie den sozialdemokratischen Bürgermeister Wobereit nicht daran gehindert, bei den Koalitionsverhandlungen einzuknicken und...
And even though experts said that it's a bad idea to make that period of time longer,
nämlich bei den Themen TTIP und CETA, also die beiden Handelsabkommen mit...
It still didn't have any effect on the Social Democrats, and we can see that again in the negotiations about TTIP and CETA.
Und auch diese Schiedsgerichte sollen sind abzulehnen, und zwar in jedem Fall.
Any kinds of,
dann war Gabriel bei der EU-Kommissarin Cecilia Malmström und meinte danach so, ja...
I do apologize, this is really difficult to translate here.
So eine richtige Option, also können wir so langsam sehen, wie es so langsam so, oh, schon so bei 45 Grad ist, und demnächst macht es boom, und dann fällt er um. Ähnlich sieht es halt aus bei dem Exportstopp von Spähsoftware.
Gerade der Gabriel ist...
Now he's talking about the, about the export of espionage spying software. And he made the he didn't look like he was interested in changing things, and he's opposed to exporting China, and we tried to tell him that it was the wrong thing, but and now he says that it won't work and it will be transparent and we'll look that nothing happens anymore. And the press asked exactly how that was in the past, and well, the thing with transparency wasn't important anymore. That's quite a difficult theme because you've got workplaces, and workplaces and workers are important, and we still make money,
and they
want their own workplaces, and well, a minister can't do anything there. There is a, what, how do you call that, a second salary?
Zum Beispiel bei den Verlagen.
For example, in
also angesichts der Editions, kann man von Aufstockung reden.
When you look at the salaries, you have to say it's just a bit on top.
Ähnliches Prinzip.
But well, it's kind of the same principle. So let's see where people stay after that. They want to get Google want to get the minister. But we do have the energy change. Well, in climate protection.
It's, and wichtig sind jetzt auch
the exit from nuclear power,
of course, part of that. Vorher war das so, Vorbedingungen. Ja, also ohne die wollen wir nicht verletzen, aber wir wollen schon
want to,
aus der Kernenergie und Klimaschutz. Und jetzt wollen wir gleichberechtigt Wettbewerbsfähigkeit und
Versorgungssicherheit. Das heißt, wir können to have the security and we don't...
Selbst wenn wir
not sure what he's talking about. Yeah, we might even change back to getting out of the atomic energy.
Ein bisschen
so it might look like that. So, yeah.
Naja, wohin es dann führt, ist natürlich irgendwie
unsere
Klassiker-Kategorie, nämlich
generator. There is also a category, the nature strikes back. And nature is, you can't stop nature. And global warming, you have to think about them, there is nothing happening. And especially not in the USA, there is absolutely no problem. That's absolutely a legend.
A myth.
This is no war. It's just snow.
Mehr als Schnee war da nicht.
There was nothing more than snow. Well, okay, maybe a bit more snow. Maybe that could look like that when the global weather is a bit, well, doesn't work anymore.
Und es gibt aber immer noch so Republikaner,
die sagen, halt so, still also, Republicans who say no.
Eigentlich nur Betrug, und eigentlich sind da die Illuminaten dahinter,
well, these are the Illuminatis,
die uns eine Weltregierung aufdrücken
and
wollen.
And there is a world government who wants to push it. Do we know that guy? And we thought, yeah, we saw that guy on that image. That's the older one.
So, was ist denn das da im Vordergrund?
What's that in the front?
Yeah.
What's that?
Kann man ein bisschen schlecht erkennen.
One doesn't see what it is. We're not sure.
Das ist bestimmt Schnee vom Global Warming.
It might be snow from global warming.
Vielleicht doch Babypuder oder so.
Maybe baby powder or something.
Ja, also das Das Wetter ist in den USA so dermaßen heimer, dass sogar das Burning Man
so strange that even Burning Man it rained of Burning Man and that's in Nevada desert and it there was problem because of the rain.
Aber von Fakten lassen sich solche Leute eh nicht aufhalten.
People just don't want to be confused by facts.
Von dem Vorsitzenden für Klimawandel zuständigen Komitees im amerikanischen Senat. Das ist nämlich dieses hier.
There is this is the book of the Congress Committee Chair.
Aber die Natur wehrt sich natürlich noch auf andere
On climate, of course.
Nicht nur im Großen, auch im Kleinen.
Genau, also in Indien hatten sie ein Problem.
In India, they also had a problem. They do have lots of vote computers and the rats ate the computers, the cables. And so the votes had some problems.
Weil dieses Wahlcomputerproblem in Indien steht ja ohnehin noch, aber wer von euch trainiert
vote computer? But who from you trains rats?
Ja, nicht nur im Mikrokosmos gibt's Naturzurückschlageprobleme,
sondern auch big größere Probleme. Nature strikes back. There are also in Southern Tyrol in France.
That's Northern Italy.
In Madagaskar gab's eine Heuschreckenplage.
There was in Madagaskar a biblical proportion crickets. There was also this information.
Bubonic plague in Madagaskar.
Lungenpest gibt.
Bubonic and pneumonic plague. You see it in the headline there. So someone gambled wrong, it seems.
Ja, wir werden noch viel mehr Pest haben.
Okay, so we think we're going to have more pest if the resistance to antibiotics, there was a new one also in China. And this year was, of course, Ebola. Was the big scare, which happened in Africa, but what happened in the West, it was, that's one controller in an airport, and he's being checked. In the USA, that's how it's a bit important, Ebola quarantine expert. That's an image of,
da standen dann noch so Leute an der Straße, die natürlich
people on the side, with so that the airport would close, even Germany.
What do I do when I believe that the person next to me in the bus bar or cinema has Ebola?
There is SWAT team. There was also the e-bowling was created when you follow the Bild-Zeitung.
Germany's largest tabloid paper, largest paper at all.
And there was even Lego.
Reaktion auf dem Kindermarkt.
Ja, there was a reaction on the children's playground. There are also some infrastructures, and you don't need to help.
Sondern die bröselt schon von sich aus.
Oder
you don't need to help the infrastructure collapsing with your keyboard. It does that by itself.
Nicht mehr aufzuhalten. Also sowas kennen wir ja. Also LKW fährt unter Brücke.
For example, you know the problem with a tunnel and a lorry.
Züge, die but
there are also trains which has the same problem in tunnels. I'm not sure how they manage that. And there was also problems created by people,
man-made problems.
For flights who disappear from radar, there was a bigger problem in Austria. They tried to radar jammers for NATO exercises and seemed it worked. The next slide is about something about an update to what we did last year, and that is finance ministry who has no money to install a fire alarm, and when they gave kazoos to the workers, so when they see
um dieses Brandschutzproblem zu lösen.
Someone gave vuvuzelas to the passengers to help.
So, das war letztes Jahr.
That was last year.
Stellt sich aber raus, dass es da tatsächlich erhebliche praktische Probleme gibt.
But there are quite problems, side effects. We could even think about them. What happens when you do an exercise
drill?
What happens? It gets loud in case of exercise, and some people actually got sick and had ear problems.
Ja, manchmal ist es nicht Infrastruktur, die wegbröselt, sondern Infrastruktur, die gar nicht
Infrastructure, which is problematic, but the infrastructure just doesn't get built. For example, there is a CDU.
So Germany's conservative party warns for to build, warns against building asylum seekers' homes too quickly.
Ja, also selbst Problem. Selbst in Bayern. Spricht das Rote Kreuz von einer humanitären Katastrophe?
Even the Red Cross talks about catastrophe. Brandenburg, which is also a land,
a state, yeah.
Well, they are closing up the
asylum seekers' homes there. Unser Innenminister
de Maizière, der sagte nämlich, wenn wir Flüchtlinge aufnehmen, haben wir Terroristen gewonnen.
And de Maizière, which is the
interior minister,
said that if we accept asylum seekers, we get terrorists.
Ja, auch die technische Infrastruktur.
The technical infrastructure is she has been privatized for a long while, and there was there are some structural weaknesses in London.
Gab es einen Wasserrohrbruch und da ist sehr viel Wasser in der Kanalisation gelaufen. Hat halt was von vorher in der Kanalisation.
Pipes broken.
So some sewage pipes broke and that led to literally a shitstorm. In German, the word shitstorm is used for a social media storm of abuse and fury.
Die Briten haben aber eigentlich Erfahrungen damit und wissen es natürlich immer zu nutzen.
The Brits of course had experience with that and know how to make use of the situation. There's lots of water damage there and there was a query for files about the UK involvement in a CIA rendition program, as you can see there. And those files, unfortunately, when there was a water leakage, were damaged, very unfortunately. And then they were salvaged as the whole press had their fun at it, then suddenly there was a way. And Brits this year had lots of bad luck, not just water can leak into a room, but also fast drying cement. And if that happens to be the server room of the underground, well, there could be some problems.
Die Lösung war ganz
lustig,
und zwar
quite
haben
funny.
Die Zucker drauf
they
gekippt.
Poured sugar on it, and you don't have sugar at hand, of course, so they're raiding the supermarkets in the city center of London, which stops cement from drying out and hardening.
Ja, aber gut, manchmal muss man gar nicht.
And sometimes you don't really have to pour cement on things to get a problem.
Das kann auch Verunreinigung geben im Wasser, dafür gibt es Filterinstallationen.
Some
aber
contamination,
but kommen die Filter nicht hinterher.
After a certain amount of use, the filters can't keep up, and this was about cocaine traces in the water, and they were wondering what is going on there, and then we were looking at one of those documentary photos and found one, looking for one, and found one, and coke, of course, is something that other people dealt with. Well, the son of Joe Biden, the American vice president, who was expelled from the U.S. Navy Reserve for cocaine abuse. So what does someone like that do then? He got a new job. He works with a company that, does energy policy in Ukraine.
Die irgendwelche Gasfelder auf der Krim
they
als
found some gas sources in the Krim as
in Deutschland
of course that's the right place to go.
Now
Berlin police will not leave anything up to chance. They were convicted because they actually instigated a drugs transaction, and judges said that this was an illegal provocation of a crime, and we found a nice photo for that too. Police are offering a trial course or a sniffing course, as the German word says literally, about cocaine for its as a drug counseling course.
Sucht mir noch eine schöne Meldung, die dazu passt.
Look for a nice news bit that fits this and found a warning in Amsterdam, where there was an alert against buying cocaine on the street, not for the usual grounds, but because people were falling down because they had been sold heroin for cocaine, because that is so much cheaper now.
Which,
this is an official Amsterdam police warning, not a fake.
You will not be arrested for using drugs in Amsterdam.
Was uns zu den Nachrichten aus der Wirtschaft bringt.
Leads us to business or news from the economy.
It's apparently a picture from the movie The Wolf of Wall Street.
Genau, warum ist Heroin so billig?
So why is heroin so cheap?
Sie haben 7 Milliarden
they spent 7 billion
in Afghanistan, die Poppy cultivation den Opiumanbau zu unterbinden.
To stop that.
Hat nicht so richtig geholfen.
Didn't quite work, didn't quite help if you look at the statistics.
Sehen wir halt
you see that the little blue ones are what's been destroyed and the large yellow columns are what they didn't manage to destroy. All round success and in the economy it always goes uphill, of course, it always goes forward. Goldman Sachs
sollte man vielleicht nicht sein Geld hintragen, zumindest hat Libyen damit so ein bisschen
get your money, carry your money. Libya had a few problems putting 1.2 billions into shares which didn't rise at all, and there was this souvenir from Goldman Sachs as a consolation prize. And there are actually some astonishing things to report, but because a former Goldman Sachs director was convicted and had to go to jail, actually had to go.
And
the only thing we could think of, hell must have frozen over.
And
in the finance sector, you have lots of people that say it's all conspiracy and that's not the way the world works and all that. And our favorite example was the gold price. The gold price this year didn't move the way you expect the gold price to move.
So, und die ganzen and, Gold Nuts haben alle
all the gold nuts said, well, this is all manipulated. The economy press said, well, you must be joking. Who would manipulate the gold price? And then it turns out HSBC, Société Générale, and Barclays, and the Deutsche Bank, and they manipulated the gold price. Very interesting this year, the statistics of individual banks, how much they had to put back for legal actions against them. These are billions of dollars that they had to put back per quarter.
This is actually expenses.
There's even more which they had to set aside. This is very interesting to read. Far larger numbers that they had to set aside. But of course, they won't give up without a fight, especially after a bailout. Keeping the bonus payments up for the bankers, the Commerzbank in this instance, which paid out bonuses. If you read that as an employee, and well, this is all about the gamblers, of course. Commerzbank had to be bailed out by the state before paying out this bonus. And the gross domestic product keeps rising, of course, so you wonder how does that all work with economic growth? This is what keeps the world running. And an interesting trick to keep this rising is a statistical one. You just include new things in the statistic.
Künftig werden nämlich auch solche Sachen wie Drogendeals,
like drug dealing, cigarette smuggling,
kommt alles mit ins Inlandsprodukt,
part of the gross domestic product.
Ist halt schon länger drinne und
prostitution and unofficial work is part of it, has been for a while, and as a result Italy is out of the recession. And they themselves.
Da waren sie selbst überrascht, als die Meldung rauskam.
When this came out.
Ja, Italien, wer die letzten Jahre bei uns dabei war, da hatten wir einmal einige Male so eine Meldung, dass da irgendwelche gefälschten Bonds aufgetaucht sind in
fake bonds in huge amounts, and that happened again. And the Vatican Bank was involved, one of the nicest, most beautiful bank buildings, this tower in the world. And there were people there that wanted to deposit those bonds. 3 billion euros on paper were carried into the bank. And it was said, we'd like to open an account. And the bank said, well, if you just wait a moment, we'll have to fetch someone. Use that room over there with that solid door, please. And the Vatican Bank, unfortunately, didn't make that much money itself, and probably because they just didn't take any of these good customers. And the Pope, of course, ordered a cleansing program and told them, what you have been doing, you can't do anymore. And the bankers then said, well, that's how we make our profits. And the Pope said, well, fuck it. And
in der Sofaritze beim Vatikan sind noch gewisse Rücklagen.
Behind the sofa in the Vatican, there are certain reserves that have a few hundred millions that they found. They were lying around, basically, under the pillow. So don't be afraid, is the line on the slide there.
From
the Vatican to another criminal, another party.
Der CDU-Schatzmeister.
CDU, German Conservative Party, whose finance person was reported about because he had for years bunkered large amounts in tax havens like Bahamas. I'm particularly fond of this election poster there. You remember the CDU? Wasn't that the case? Walter Leisler-Kiep, wasn't he the master of the black suitcase? In previous governments, they have experts there, and they made one of those the finance person. But he denied all this and said this was all his private company and it was all taxed properly.
Sure.
Now, speaking of taxing things properly or filing tax returns properly, and of course, U.S. election campaigns are special and they'll become even more special because the limit for donating has been raised or abolished by the Supreme Court. And they decided, well, it can't look like corruption, no matter how much money you invest in a party. Since when do party donations lead to corruption? We never heard anything like that, did we? And one of the large donors was the Chevron company, which is involved in fracking, and that's how it looks if things go wrong. But they are socially responsible and care of communities. And if small accidents like this happen, as they did this year, they make sure that they don't appear in such a bad light. It wasn't just damage, by the way, people died, but they dealt out gift certificates. People were given pizza coupons. Well, yeah.
Brot und Spiele.
This is bread. What's the Latin phrase? Bread and games.
Panem et circenses.
Panem et circenses. Yeah, thank you. So we were looking at this a bit more closely, and the brown curve here is the oil price. Brent crude, the most important, which took down other variants, other kinds of oil as well. But what does that actually mean? We were looking at the oil reserves, wondering how much of these are in the OPEC countries and how many are elsewhere, and can all this fracking actually move this so much and change this? And is that perhaps a coincidence that these movements are taking place, or can you actually interpret something? And the interesting curve is here. What you see is in red are the countries which will get into a budget deficit if a certain oil price is reached, and the other countries to the left and right are those that will be able to deal with that. And what we can see, if the oil price drops sharply, those that are hit are actually all the large oil-producing countries. You can tell that even fracking isn't worth it anymore. If you have about $110 per barrel, and below that, fracking really isn't worth it, which leads to all these fracking companies making losses now. And especially Russia and Saudi Arabia are actually making losses now. So this oil price is probably actually a political weapon that is being used. And the other theory that is just as plausible is that the fundamental economic countries, the fundamental data, economic data that we see is actually complete fake, and the oil price actually reflects oil consumption, which is falling because the economies aren't growing. Well, apart from prostitution and drug stealing and all that, but you don't need that much oil for that. But everyone, all these states use the low oil price to fill their reserves. Germany too has strategic oil reserves, which are in a salt mine, or several salt mines, and these Well, you know that salt mines are also used for dumping nuclear waste because nothing can leak from there, or you can use them for oil. And here we have oil traces found in the groundwater in German places. And you have these people, the Exxon Mobil chief who has a private ranch, and when there was fracking supposed to be happening, he was concerned not because of environmental reasons, but it would lower the value of his property. But you can think for yourself what's behind that. So the falling oil price, of course, is causing Russia problems. So what should you do? And Russia has its own tradition of countermeasures. Here you see how the new religious advisory council for Gazprom is at work, and you see the ruble falling too, which caused one of their priests to bless the servers.
The
ruble central bank at the ruble central bank of the Russian central bank that looks after the ruble, and they actually bless anything that won't be up on the trees on the count of three: airplanes, rockets, space rockets, weapons. Well, they are very flexible with giving up blessings. Maybe it will help. Who knows?
Yeah, Wirtschaft ist natürlich immer ein bisschen.
The economy is always a bit difficult for people that like numbers. States always offer these numbers, and someone was caught. The Sprint company was probably just pulling over the Americans for wiretapping, and we're wondering, how does that come about? Is that intentional? And the thing is, they tried to first take legal action against the NSA getting data, and then they realized maybe we'll charge them for getting data from us. And when they agreed a price that was far above the actual cost of getting that data, that they were happy with that. Of course, you can't finance the world economy from that. There was this stability report from the currency fund, the monetary fund, which said things aren't looking that well, it's all very complex. And the International Monetary Fund had this graphic for the amount of stability that there still is. As you can see, they have an interesting metric that they looked at. If you look at all the companies altogether and then look at the subset that earn less than they have to pay as interest on their debts, then in Europe you have In the southern countries, you have between 30% and 40%. For Greece, they don't even want to say what the percentage is.
So viele Firmen sind eigentlich insolvent.
These are the companies that are basically insolvent. This is not what they have to pay. They used to pay back the debts, but only for the interest on their debts. And of course, that's where competition hits hard, and you have to then take things into your hands and become hands-on. Someone went into the media market, a large retailer of electric goods, and took a hammer to competitors' products and said he was only trying to conduct a stability test. Just wanted to see how much the doors would be wobbling and things like that. And they had to let him go when he actually bought all the machines that he had damaged.
Ja, wie bleibt man unter solchen ökonomischen Umständen?
Under economic circumstances like this, do you stay in power? And there was a very innovative method in Turkey. In the provinces where things weren't looking so well for President Erdogan, on the election day, the electricity was off suddenly, very inventive, and what would have been better was if they had done this for the electronic voting machines, if they had them. But if the electricity goes out, street lights go out, people will not tend to go voting, I assume, which leads us to some place where, close to our hearts, the cryptocalypse.
It's a little bigger this year. We start with a message from Switzerland. Switzerland, apparently, the experts who are managing the keys for the Swiss government, they were having some, all sorts of problems. Apparently, a piece of hardware failed and they couldn't get to their central recovery key anymore. They said, we can pretty much rule out any involvement of a third party. I don't really know how they can do that, but
I got nothing.
Maybe it was on top of a Swiss mountain. There were a lot of failures this year. Here are a couple of attractive ones.
Aber man kann vielleicht sagen, okay, der ein oder andere hier im Publikum betrifft mich nicht, ich nehme Linux.
Some of you may say, I don't care, I use Linux.
Linux lief auch nicht so gut.
Linux wasn't really doing so well this year either. We had a couple of cases.
Ja gut, nimmt man halt Windows, nicht wahr?
And you say, okay, well, in that case, I'll just use Windows.
Also jetzt hypothetisch gesprochen.
Well, hypothetically, you could probably do
auch
that.
Bei Windows lief's nicht so gut.
But Windows was also affected.
Naja, dann virtualisieren wir halt. Well, ja, das ist ja der Trend.
You might say, okay, so let's go ahead and virtualize everything. And that looked quite good until Amazon had to reboot all of their servers because they had been applying an update and they had to do a reboot of all their virtual machines. And then, of course, we had the thing with the electronic voting. Well, let's just say to do. We'll just get to that when we have the time.
Eine ähnliche Qualitätsstufe ist auch an anderer Stelle beobachtet.
Something of a very similar quality here in an economic area. This is the Xbox. A 5-year-old noticed that when he keeps pressing the space bar, the system will actually log him in.
Das mit der Technik wird ja immer einfacher.
The thing with all the technical things are getting easier and easier. We're getting more and more child-friendly. Microsoft is a leader here. We have this very nice case.
Wer mehr Security-Probleme hören will,
if you want to hear more about security problems, I can only...
Da wird das alles in Ruhe im Detail besprochen.
We'll discuss all that in detail in the Security Nightmares talk in 2 days. A new section that we have is our so-called... real politics section. So if you know these war criminals,
well,
I guess if there was an international court that was actually working, they would all be taken into custody.
Since
we're talking about war criminals, here's another one. One special field of this kind of politics is the pipeline politics. Mr. Joschka Fischer, he's been working for an advisor for the Nabucco company, putting pipelines into Russia, and in his, as a consultant, he made some statements about the next Cold War, and it's supposed to be happening with gas and natural gas resources. He predicted that for 2010, but last year Nabucco plans failed, so the gas that's coming from Azerbaijan is not going through the Nabucco pipelines, but they're using a different one that goes through Italy.
Eines der Felder, die
and
wo
one of the areas
war dann natürlich die Frage, wie kommt dann eigentlich das russische Erdgas sonst nach Europa?
Is always working on is figuring out how the gas from the Russians is getting to Europe. And there was this project called South Stream, where the Russians were supposed to put their gas through the Black Sea and through Bulgaria, and this was blocked by the European Union. This pipeline.
Als gescheitert erklärt und hat Putin gesagt,
na gut, dann failure, and then Putin said, okay, then we'll just deliver our gas and our oil to Turkey. So basically he said, dear Europeans, when you don't want to play with us, then you have to ask the Turks if they are willing to give you some of the oil and the gas.
Und Fischer, naja, musste natürlich auch noch irgendwie, nachdem er
Fischer obviously he had to figure out what to do after the job at Nabucco went downhill. So together with the former Minister of the Exterior Albright
Siemens,
he worked as a consultant in nuclear questions for the Siemens company. Another core company of the Green Party is, of course, Freude am Fahren, which is something that the BMW company used as a slogan. So that's why he's also a lobbyist for BMW now. So sometimes the economy and the environmental aspects overlap. We had this problem in Canada where the building a pipeline actually threatened a certain type of whales. So what the Canadian government did is they simply reduced the protection level for this kind of whales so they could build their pipelines. And we have a little illustration here. This is the Exxon Valdez.
But
protecting the environment and protecting species is not only a problem in Canada, but also in the German state of Thuringia. We have this picture that we had this minister who posted these pictures on Facebook, and he was actually in Africa. He posted this picture while he was attending a conference against the trade of ivory. But of course you can have fun at work. This is the Japanese and the Chinese Secretary of State, and they seem to like each other.
Und auch Frau Merkel hat immer wieder.
Obviously, Mrs. Merkel.
Spaß. Zumindest der Putin hat Spaß.
She seems to have fun. Well, at least Mr. Putin seems to have fun.
Aber Frau Merkel mag andere Menschen lieber. Ne?
Mrs. Merkel, she likes other people better.
Business is great.
And the sign actually says business is great.
And
of course, you have to deal with unusual requests, for example, from the Ukraine. Vitaly Klitschko has asked Germany for their expertise on building walls. Because he said, you have the experience, you certainly have some old plans lying around that we could use. And I guess he maybe remembers some of these old brochures that the Christian Democrats used a couple of years ago. The Ukraine is a very exciting area this year. So what did we have? For example, the Minister of the Exterior.
Genau, die sich mit dem amerikanischen Botschafter in der Ukraine unterhielt.
Was talking to the ambassador of the US on the phone, and we know that everyone is always spying on everyone, so.
So that would be great, I think, to help glue this thing and have the UN help glue it. And, you know, fuck the EU.
No, exactly. And I think we've got to do something to make it stick together.
Ich finde besonders schön, wie der nicht eine Schrecksekunde hat, sondern
yeah, what I really like is that he doesn't really miss a beat. He just...
Damit also die EU wollte sich natürlich darüber informieren.
The European Union was interested in that.
Was hat die da gesagt? Das Problem war, sie konnten nicht, weil ihre Pornofilter zugeschlagen haben.
But they couldn't, because actually the porn filter filtered out that particular word.
So, was war das Bild oben links gerade?
So what did we have in the top left corner there, in the upper left corner? What did we have there? Did you pay attention to that?
Das war doch die Timoschenko.
That was Mrs. Timoschenko.
Und auch die hat dieses Jahr ein YouTube-Problem gehabt.
And she also had a problem with YouTube this year.
Ja, die hatte auch Sprüche von sich auf YouTube. Also wir scheinen offenbar jetzt mit in der Phase zu sein, wo alle wissen, dass alle von her on YouTube. Dementsprechend doch alle leaken.
So apparently
gerade in der Türkei.
Everything about everyone leaks.
Da gab es dann Dialoge vom ehemaligen Premierminister, dem jetzigen Premierminister, mit dem Geheimnischef und noch so einem General, die halt einfach mal am Telefon diskutierten, wie sie einen Krieg anzetteln können, indem sie halt da so ein paar Special Forces irgendwo hinschicken,
by sending a ship somewhere or simulate
der hilfreiche Geheimdienstchef schlägt das vor, kommen halt ein paar Männer aus Syrien.
Und das landete halt eben auch auf YouTube.
Very nice proposals and all that.
Daraufhin hat die Türkei YouTube ausgemacht,
and
weil
basically the reaction was that YouTube was disabled in Turkey.
Braucht man ja nicht. Polen war auch kurz davor.
For whatever reasons.
In Polen gab's
in Poland we had something very similar here.
Den polnischen Außenminister, der sich auch relativ stringent darüber äußerte.
He had some very strong words.
We believe that everything is fantastic only because we just blew the Americans.
Fragen Sie natürlich, was macht man
the Americans blowjob.
Ministerpräsident
that's why we think everything is fantastic.
Tusk hat sich dann natürlich erstmal von Putin die Regeln erklären lassen und dann mochte er sie offenbar nicht. Hat er sich noch von seinem Freund Cameron berichten lassen, wie macht ihr denn das da so mit der Presse so? Und dann hat er ihm offenbar die Geschichte mit dem Guardian und den Festplatten erzählt.
Jedenfalls
kam es dann dazu, dass die Pressefreiheit auf Polnisch neu interpretiert wurde. Und was wir hier sehen, ist die Szene, die polnische Geheimpolizisten versuchen, dem Redakteur einer Zeitung den Notebook zu entreißen.
What we see here is that policemen are trying to grab the laptop of a member of the press here in Poland.
He's
a journalist for the newspaper that published that article.
Die Briten, ja, die and sind da Brits, auch nicht so zufällig, die sagen schon mal
nicht nur die Pressefreiheit ist da schon länger abgeschafft, aber die Briten haben auch gesagt, ja, also das mit den Menschenrechten, das inkludiert uns so ein bisschen,
well,
weil wir hier so ein paar Hassprediger
really
ausweisen würden und die werden aber zu Hause mit Folter bedroht und das ist unser Weg und da möchten wir gerne die ausweisen können und die Menschenrechte ignorieren können,
like
die
europäische Revolution.
Und die haben gesagt, ja, also entweder
basically what they said,
wir kriegen ein Vetorecht für Entscheidungen des Europäischen Menschenrechtsgerichtshofs. Auf die Idee muss man erstmal kommen, das zu fordern. Ja. Oder wir treten da halt aus.
You have to have some chutzpah to kind
das
of
so
demand that. Or they said, we will just leave the
European
Union.
Strafgerichtshof.
Kind of reminds you of the way the Americans treat those international courts. There is an American law.
Den Haag Invasions.
Genau, Den Haag-Invasionsakt heißt,
is called the Den Haag Rights to Invade Den Haag, basically.
Amerikaner wegfängt, um sie zu verurteilen.
Means if the international court
sentences
American citizens, the American government is actually obligated
so,
to free them using force.
Sich der holländischen Regierung zu dem Thema
you can kind of imagine the faces of the Dutch government there.
Aber wo wir gerade beim Umgang der Amerikaner mit Gesetzen waren.
While we're talking about the US and how they treat their laws.
Das FBI kennt man ja eigentlich als Polizeibehörde.
The FBI is usually known as a police agency.
This
is no longer the case. It's now an intelligence agency. Because the main purpose of the FBI is no longer law enforcement. But now it is national security. Normally you would think that they have enough intelligence agencies, but well, come on.
Gut, ja, dann haben wir nach den Snowden-Entwicklungen haben wir gelernt, dass
the revelations
gibt, was
of Snowden we learned
ausläuft,
that there is a law that
die NSA ermächtigt, die ganzen Daten
that actually enables the NSA to
und dann haben wir uns
spy
naiv
on
gedacht,
everyone and everything.
Andere, na ja, dann verlängern die das halt nicht.
And some people
were
maybe
geprüft,
thinking
ja,
that they wouldn't
stellt sich raus, das wird also turnusmäßig
renew this law, but it turns out that this law is, is renewed every 40 days, because
aber
the law is only valid for 40 days, so they just
also
keep renewing it.
Eine Nachrichtenmeldung wenigstens.
And by now it's just a normal item in the news.
Aber die deutschen
just,
nicht daran, irgendwie ganz super Beziehungen zu den
but the German intelligence agency, they stress that they have a very good relationship to the U.S. agencies.
Here is a statement da eigentlich keine Probleme haben, nach wie vor sind die Beziehungen gut.
The relationships are still very good, there are no problems at all.
And
there is no danger to the German economy.
Das war auch genau das Problem, wenn wir uns
coming from the NSA.
Ja, der Verfassungsschutz als Geheimdienst ist natürlich irgendwie auch genau die richtigen Leute, die wissen, wie man sowas macht so und wie man
of course the intelligence agency, they are the right people to rebuild confidence.
Deswegen wollen sie halt erstmal 55 neue Stellen für IT-Sicherheit, weil
and this is why there are 45 new workplaces being created for cyber security. Of course, we do have to ask, who pays them? And or for the BND, it's okay, but who pays the NSA? Of course, it is the tax. But which one? Well, and it happens, even the German one, German citizens pay for the NSA. So, how do you stop it? And there was this company called Blackwater, and they had some people in Iraq, and why are they still there? And they even have a murder accusation. And there was a committee to inquest, and they talked with the people from Blackwater, and they said, you know what, if you have to check it, you've got to come to Iraq, and if you come to Iraq, well, we'll kill you. And, well, no thing happened. So they also tried to get their role models in the media. Oh, Apple Software.
Let's try again.
I could have killed them all. I could have killed you. Been telling you the law about you, it's me. Don't push it. Don't push it, I'll give you a war you won't believe.
And that was an extract from
the
first blood, I think. First Rambo film.
Da stellt man schon mal die Untersuchung ein. Ja, wir kommen zu einem alten Bekannten.
So let's go back to an old friend, the Richard Nixon Lame Excuse Award.
Und das war ein echtes Problem. And that was a einfach real so viele big problem,
because there were so much lame excuses.
Ein bisschen zusammenzudampfen so versucht, aber
we tried to
da müssen jetzt
work on it.
Es gab auch eine harte Konkurrenz. Also die NSA.
Conference. So the NSA, of course, right at the forefront,
lawful, appropriate,
lawful and appropriate for intelligence operations. And
aber wir sind natürlich bemüht, in so einer Kategorie dann auch Europa zu repräsentieren.
Genau.
So, und da bot sich dieses Jahr Österreich an. Der Telekom-Experte der ÖVP hat erklärt, warum jetzt da die Qualität schon aus technischen Gründen gar nicht geht. Ja,
so,
geht nicht.
I didn't get it.
Net neutrality just won't work in Austria.
Ja, dann gab es ja diesen Fall, dass wieso unternimmt die deutsche Regierung nichts gegen der Drohnenkrieg der USA?
Okay, there is the further the war in drone wars from Rammstein.
Und die Bundesregierung sagt,
and the German government says we don't know anything about it. And the US government told us nothing's happening, so everything's okay.
Rammstein being in US airbase in Germany.
And so there is this guy who is responsible for Bundesanwalt.
Yeah, he's state prosecutor.
Okay. We're going to see him a bit more today. So he actually saw that there is nothing to do and drones cannot be.
There is no malice in using drones. Drones are not banned. But instead, some laser pointer fun from the audience.
Yeah.
And there is no authorized war list.
It's an
admissible trick of war.
Da gibt's keine Zeugen oder Dokumente.
They tried in vain to get documents from Edward Snowden.
Wollten wir uns natürlich mal einen Eindruck von der gesamten
Qualifications.
Selbstverständlich. Ich möchte Sie über den sogenannten NSA-Komplex informieren.
Das hat
unsere Erkenntnisfragen haben bislang keine konkreten Anhaltspunkte dafür ergeben, dass die NASA oder das GCHQ den deutschen Telefon- und Internetverkehr systematisch
monitor.
I like how he called the NSA first SNA and then NASA.
Oh, did he?
He did.
I missed that. Nice.
And that kind of stresses his confidence, his competence.
I'd like to inform you about the state of the so-called SNA complex.
Yes, there it was.
Unsere Erkenntnisfragen haben bislang keine konkreten Anhaltspunkte dafür ergeben, dass die NASA GCHQ
systematically eavesdropping on German telephone internet communications. So this guy obviously knows what he is talking about.
Dann haben wir uns gab es noch ein paar andere tolle Ausreden von ihm, nämlich
few other lame excuses, great lame excuses.
Das war gar nicht von ihm, sondern
this actually wasn't by him, but netzpolitik.org, the German blog, asked the ministry in charge and asked what would happen if there would be any classified documents from other countries.
And
the response was that illegal publishing would not remove classification and public servants would only be allowed to read classified materials if they had the clearance, and classified material from abroad
is underlying the same protections as the classified material from their own country. So these people were actually not allowed to read any leaked materials. And so how does that all look like behind the scenes? And we had this nice statement from the US politics coordinator in the call area in the 80s and 90s. And he said that, well, Americans we always respond, you can't do that with us, we brought you democracy, and if there are serious disagreements, then there would be classified material that would be a burden on Germany, would see Germany in bad light, and that would be used as for blackmail. And the one reason, apparently, to spy on Germany is worries about Russian morals in Berlin. The U.S. actually aren't spying on us, said the slide.
Yeah, es gab noch einen anderen interesting case from ansässigen Geheimdienst der Bundesbehörde, nämlich der
Federal Agency in the US, which has intelligence functions the NRO, National Reconnaissance Office, who run the spy satellites in the US. And there was, this is a high security area, and there are routine lie detector tests where employees have to confess their sins, and one of them spontaneously told about the fact that he was abusing minors, and you would assume that if something like that comes out in an authority like that, he would go to the police, which wasn't done. It did come out later, and there was the statement then that they were forced to, saw themselves forced to give out, and here it is, the victims could have called the police themselves. These are the people that have logos like this. So morally sound personnel, you can say, and the influence from TV serials on politics is something that's been interesting to us for a long time. And here's a nice example in England, in Britain. David Cameron said that we need data retention.
Man kann doch in TV-Serien sehen, dass
you can see in TV series that it helps.
Wir haben hier mal ein Beispiel rausgesucht, wie das weitergehen wird. Ja, wenn wir
back for the way this will continue.
For weeks I've been investigating the cabbie killer murders with a certain morbid fascination.
This is in real time. I'll create a GUI interface using Visual Basic. See if I can track an IP address.
Also wir können uns da in England noch auf einiges gefasst machen.
In Britain you can expect a lot of things to come.
Wenn sie dann anfangen, User Interfaces in Visual Basic zu machen.
Do User Interfaces in Visual Basic. It's actually quite in demand these days, I've heard. Technology is difficult in Poland. 18 US helicopters went missing on the way back from Lithuania. This can happen, of course. We don't have any guiding systems these days, do we? They just went, of course, they just lost their way. Slide says they'll have to be updated. And the other story was a bit embarrassing because a few days beforehand, a few Russian soldiers lost their way in Ukraine.
Und das war eigentlich nicht glaubwürdig.
This wasn't very credible, according to German media.
I have no memory of this place.
Ja, wie ist denn das, wenn man so als Strafverfolgungsbehörde eine E-Mail lesen will und die liegt aber
prosecuting
gar nicht
authority
in eigenen Land,
read an E-Mail that's not in your country,
da
but from another country?
Of
course, there are legal aid agreements for that, so the police will then go ahead. And the problem is that you actually have to have a paper trail to prove that you have a legitimate interest to read this, and this is, of course, demanding, which is what the Justice Department in the US thinks legal aid is too complex. We need worldwide purview.
Medienkommunikation ist immer so ein bisschen schwierig. Ne?
Of course, it's difficult.
Da gab es diesen Spruch von Poroschenko,
Poroshenko, Ukraine president, who talked about an invasion, and that was then corrected, and it was said, no, this is not, did we say invasion? That must have been a mistype, typo that can happen. So here is a suggestion, use Google Translate. What I found quite funny was this example,
where
content was reused, this rocket.
This was in Russland gelandet, once einmal in Ukraine gelandet, einmal in Israel.
Landing in Russia, then in Ukraine, and then in Israel. Same picture.
Ja, und obendrein ist wahrscheinlich sogar ein Photoshop.
And on top of that is probably photoshopped as well.
Australien ist natürlich auch immer mit dabei.
Australia, of course, is always involved as well. The Australian prosecutor said,
die Stationierung von mehr Militär im Nahen Osten zu rechtfertigen. Nein, das ist kein Krieg.
Well,
nein,
this is not a war. We just have a humanitarian mission here with military elements.
Illustriert.
And we've illustrated that.
Auch ein sehr großartiges Beispiel für eine Nixon-würdige Ausrede
Nixon,
war der Verleihung des Alternativen Nobelpreises
the award of the Alternative Peace Nobel Prize to Edward Snowden.
Der wird seit 18 Jahren im schwedischen Außenministerium für
Außenminister awarded by the Swedish Exterior Ministry.
Dieses Jahr sagt das Außenministerium ab, als ihm bekannt wurde oder klar wurde, wer jetzt der Preisträger sein wird,
it was known who the winner would be.
Außenministerium wohnt
traditionell im Verdauungsorgan der Amerikaner. Is actually more located in the digestive tract of the Americans. Of course, there is no link to Edward Snowden for the calling off of the award. It was just new security regulations. And we then looked, and there was actually a talk
Karl Bild,
between Karl Bild, the person on the right, with the American State Secretary, who said, well, no, you can't do that, can you?
Ja, wir kommen wieder ins Inland.
Back to the interior, to domestic issues, where the question was, is it right if the military intelligence service, BND, is spying us? But of course, these data are acquired in space, and no one can then have anything against that. It's not under German law, is it? Another nice story from the US was the police not telling courts that they were using IMSI captures. And the great response was, well, the maker said, we have to sign this non-disclosure agreement before we use these.
Das war ein längerer Story arc.
That was a longer story arc, which we'll come back to.
Genau.
Remember the IMSI capture.
Dann gab es ein denkwürdiges Statement,
noteworthy statement from the German security authorities why they cannot.
Denn die sind nicht so blöd wie die Dschihadisten.
Intercept PKK fighters, because they're not as stupid as the jihadists.
The
PKK rebels have not yet posted any photos in social media, and that's why we have problems to find out whether they go to Syria or not.
Ja, in Kalifornien gab's
yes, and in California there was a noteworthy moment of honesty when the question was, why don't we release more people from the prisons? And the response was, we need those as slaves, for example, fighting forest fires. And there was a serious argument, well, global warming might maybe a hoax, but we have more and more forest fires, we need those people.
In den USA gab es dann noch die schöne Frage, warum halt nice question, kann die NSA dann eigentlich
the NSA
nicht
actually, why can they not,
aufzeichnen, was sie da
record
tun
what they do,
ja, dafür sorgen, dass sie
belastbare sure Ansagen treffen, have, was sie getan hat?
Ja, ist zu komplex.
Just find solid proof for what they say, and the response was, it was too complex. Great, I'll do this for my next tax return. I'll just say too complex as well.
Es gibt auch positive Aspekte zu berichten. Immer wichtiger wird der Datenschutz,
well,
auch bei den Ausländern.
Becoming more and more important is data protection, even with the lame excuses.
Die NSA says that Snowden's Arbeitspapiere können sie nicht veröffentlichen,
weil Datenschutz. Cannot be published due to
privacy reasons.
Sie können auch nicht antworten darauf, ob sie jetzt
Abgeordnete abhören oder
nicht. Whether they spy on members of Congress.
Das Auswärtige Amt kann auch nicht zu uns Asylantrag sagen wegen Datenschutz.
The German Exterior Ministry cannot say anything about Snowden's asylum application, and there was this nuclear accident.
And
of course, it would violate the privacy of the victims if we would say how much radiation was actually
they were exposed to.
Which gets us to the next, the Anatoly Bugorsky Award for Applied Nuclear Security, the next category. Anatoly Bugorsky Award for Applied Nuclear Security, named after a physicist.
Menschen, he was the only person known to have put his head into
particle accelerator's ray and survived.
Ja, da gab es einen Fall, der mir wirklich sehr große Freude bereitet hat.
Really gave me a lot of joy.
Sind what we see here Atommüllfässer in dieser Atommüllverarbeitungs- und Isolierungsanlage.
Und
das ist übrigens eine militärische Installation.
Da lagern Atommüllabfälle des Militärs, nicht zivil. Military
die werden normalerweise Abfälle mit Katzenstreu gebunden. Also es ist halt so ein Kieselruhr, halt so ein Mineralpulver, was halt dafür sorgt, dass es halt trocken bleibt.
They mixed with kitty litter,
the idea organisch, ne? Also können auch hier was auch mal
this is all organic,
biologisch abbaubar.
Genau.
Aber eigentlich will man das ja bei Atommüll nicht, dass
and that's not what you want, is it?
Hat sich denn biologisch
not with nuclear waste, it was actually degraded.
Angefangen zu blubbern und durch die Gegend zu strahlen, diese Abfälle rauszusprudeln, weil dieser Katzenstreu halt aus Sägespänen war.
Because this cat litter
was from
sawdust and we had the first bio-nuclear accident. I think they changed the formula for this cat litter. I remember reading this and didn't tell.
Die nächste Folie haben wir erst gedacht,
next slide we thought is a clear case for the Nixon Awards, but as it turns out,
genau. In Kasachstan ist tatsächlich Kasachstan,
Cesium-137 simply fell off a lorry.
Off the back of a lorry. Also wie wird man so ein Atomkraftwerk wieder los?
How do you get rid of a nuclear power station? It's not so simple. They tried it in Stade at the River Elbe in northern Germany and
noticed that the levels in the base was
164,000 becquerel per kilogram. They had a Geiger counter and they thought they were having one with a bent pointer, but they didn't find one. And
in Britain, they put their nuclear waste
in places where you wonder, why could anyone have that idea near the coast? You know, sea levels are rising, and now the nuclear waste is lying near the coast, and you can actually calculate when this storage will be swept into the sea.
And then,
of course, it's all diluted. Yeah, that was probably the plan.
Now, in Leibstadt in der Schweiz power station
in Leibstadt in Switzerland,
Löcher there were primary holes containment, in the primary containment gebohrt, that were drilled in there
to fix fire extinguishers.
Und dann haben wir uns haben wir uns gefragt, nach welchem Manual gingen die da vor?
Manual were they using and what could the nuclear safety procedures be? And we found them. This is the manual.
Als sie dann mal ein bisschen geforscht haben, seit wann diese Löcher da eigentlich sind, kam raus,
dass
es bei einer Inspektion aufgefallen, die nicht mal jedes Jahr stattfindet, sondern nur alle 10 oder so. Und diese Löcher sind schon seit 6 Jahren.
Just every 10 years and the holes have been there for 6 years.
Yeah. So sieht dann so eine Inspektion aus.
That's what this kind of inspection looks like. That's probably what they found.
Ja. Neu in der Show ist der Brezhnev Award for Transparency in Politics and Society.
Who of you know, still remembers who Leonid Brezhnev was?
A few of you. This was
before they had a sequence of quickly dying general secretaries, and then Gorbachev, there was this neo-Stalinist who closed all the doors again
and
was the head there for a large part of the Cold War. You remember the story he had about the EMC catcher and then the stingrays.
And
so someone went
asking for the files.
Von dem Bundesland, um das
the ACLU
Florida,
asked for the files, and they
und die haben looked
at states of Florida Freedom of Information legislation and asked for the files, and the police said, well, we have to, okay, let's arrange a date. And a few hours beforehand, the police called the ACLU and said, sorry, we have to call off because the Marshal Service went along and took all the files out. This is a federal authority, which is actually responsible for transporting prisoners, but quickly they sent a deputy. Well, they went there and said to this one policeman, you are the deputy now, you asked, as you know from the Western movies, and you have to do what we say, get these files from over there and put them in our car.
Ja, hohe Standards bei US-Behörden, wir kommen zur nächsten US-Behörde, die Drug Enforcement Agency, die machen so verfassungskonform und unproblematische
juristische Einwandfreiheiten,
wir müssen hier mal ein bisschen schneller machen, damit alle
noch mal ein bit,
neu in der Transparenzoffensive der NSA, Transparency Offensive by the NSA, so
Internet companies can now publish down to the 250 how many NSA letters they have received, security letters. Now, Merkel wanted to see her NSA file, but she wouldn't get it. A US court wanted to see NSA files.
And then the EFF found that offensichtlich ihre Shredder etwas extensiver benutzt haben.
Weil die Shredders had been used fairly more extensively because these files simply weren't there anymore. What's the new, which ones are interesting, they shredded them. This is actually the shredder from the Teufelsberg installation that we were talking about. Translating this talk into German.
In Deutschland wollte natürlich auch der NSA-Ausschuss seine NSA-Akten sehen.
Of course, the NSA Parliamentary Committee in German Parliament wanted to see their NSA files.
Ströbele, the Green member,
saw one and quoted from it.
Genau, die fing halt mit der Begrüßung an, dann kam die gesperrten Seiten und dann
we mit freundlichen have the following to tell you, and then there were completely blank, blacked out pages, and anything, the only thing that was still there was
das war so krass,
sincerely, yours sincerely at the bottom. This was so incredible that even these conservatives found that too much, didn't like it.
Aber wenn es mit dem Schwarzen zu anstrengend ist, muss man auch mal machen und so, dann halten sie die Akten einfach zurück.
Hard, then you just hold back the files.
Auch eine tolle Ausrede war,
great excuse here was,
die Pirate Bay wollte Pirate Bay mal wanted to know
what is actually going on in the City of London. This particular entity for the finance district, what files are there? And then the response was, no, we'll need longer than 18 hours to get those, so we won't do that for you. And then there was this scandal about controlling secret services in the US, intelligence agencies, who had been hacking into Senate computers where the report was being written. This was the committee tasked with oversight over the intelligence agencies, and they actually got files that would have enabled them to carry out their function, but the NSA had to do something about that. So we then looked who is actually responsible for oversight of the intelligence agencies and found one of those all clean.
Ja, die Transparenz offensive goes on.
There's a new review policy
for people
that used to work there, and these people cannot even quote from public news reports that contain classified documents. They cannot use any leaks. This was used to be a way of being able to talk about something that would be classified if you can't talk about it yourself. But it has been published somehow, you can start to talk. And that is why Mr. Obama is this year's recipient of the Brezhnev Award.
Ja, Fefes Lieblingsrubrik ist ja immer,
well, the da war wohl der Zensor peeing. Favorite category of Fefe is where the censor is peeing. We had one case where a US member of Congress made a statement about the conflict in the Middle East, and he had a very nice metaphor. He said, well, that war down there, that is like using your lawnmower.
Party's over.
that the lawnmower man? I'm not sure. All right, now,
about
eavesdropping on the German government,
press spokesperson.
Mr. Seibert stressed that the NSA just has to ask for the information that it wants and will simply tell them. And in Hong Kong, they had an issue that they...
Und dann hat der zuständige, im Moment zuständige Stadthalter gesagt, ja, im Moment, wenn die alle wählen dürfen, die ganzen Armen, dann sind die Armen alle stimmberechtigt.
So all the poor ones in Hong Kong, if they suddenly have the right to vote.
Apparently he had a problem with poor people voting.
And there is... Moment, die Krebsmedikamente, die wir entwickeln, die sind nicht für die armen Inder, sondern für die...
And there was this other statement from a Bayer CEO, he said that they're not developing cancer medicine for poor people.
Short announcement from Obama.
In den USA gab's einen bemerkenswerten
In the US, there was a very remarkable fuck-up where the lame excuses became very apparent. One, a reporter from NBC queried the US Navy according to the Freedom of Information Act. And instead of sending an answer, they accidentally sent him a document outlining how they were trying to weasel out of this request.
Also ein ganz großer Kandidat für wie da ist der Finger mal pinkeln ist Joe Biden.
A candidate is also Joe Biden, the American Vice President. He said, well, we tried to get the European Union to do something against Putin and we had to bully the European Union a little bit in order to pay for all that. And it looks like the... even though we had all these sanctions against Russia, American companies apparently have no problem cooperating with Russian companies and drill for oil. So apparently they are not sensitive to all these embargoes.
So, genau, der Wiener Akademiker Ball.
The academic ball in Vienna. We kind of wondered, what did they do there? This, by the way, is the head of police in Vienna. And he said,
also Rettung heißt für den die Polizei in Riot Gear, ne? Wie heißt da Rettung in Österreich?
It's basically a good thing that the police showed up in Riot Gear and used, it was necessary to use force and to use weapons. And apparently it turned out that he was a member of a...
Ja, bei der Polizei gibt es häufiger so Fälle, dass Polizisten angeklagt werden wegen angeblichen Gewalt.
Of a fraternity, which started that.
Da werden dann andere Polizisten als Zeugen gerufen und die erinnern sich dann häufig an nichts.
So apparently when you use other policemen as witnesses, they suddenly suffer from memory loss. And there was this case of another policeman. It was about the NSU who did a number of murders over a period of time, and several policemen had already said that they cannot remember anything. And there was one statement that he said that he suddenly decided to remember.
At the bottom, it's a spontaneously Alzheimer remission.
And apparently, sometimes there are also spontaneous outbursts of truth. When they abbreviated the NSU with the letters of the Christian Democrats, which is the conservative party in Germany. But the clear winner of this area is Dick Cheney, who said, well, sure, we tortured. Well, actually, he said, this report says that our intelligence agencies kind of went over the top and did that on their own terms. But he said, that's not right. They were always under our control. We knew what they were doing. And he kind of did this in multiple steps. And after that, he said, well, obviously, President Bush also okayed all that. So he not only got himself into a lot of trouble, but also his buddies. And very successful this year was all that hard police work. I kind of need that vest. I want to have one of these vests. And the US, there are a lot of things. For example, the police ask someone to come out of the vehicle, step out of the vehicle with her hands up, and the car was kind of wedged between these two, this tree and this post there, and that's when they opened fire. In Germany, we use about as much ammunition per year as the US police uses in a single incident. But apparently there are new standards for weapons training, and they said basically what the comb is for a barber, that is the weapon for us, and this is how we interpret this.
I think it's also seems Lucky from Luke. Lucky Luke movie. Yeah.
The Americans are way ahead of us, and they are also very pragmatic. That's what they are known for. There was this one case where the director of the DHS, and he forgot his laser pointer, and what he did is he was just using the laser pointer from his gun as a replacement for his normal laser pointer. In a high security area where normally carrying a gun is not allowed, in front of a delegation of heads of police from other countries, one might add.
I mean,
this is what that looks like when the...
Too short, all of them talking about Glock 40. Okay, I'm the only one in this room professional enough that I know of to carry this Glock 40. I'm the only
one. Schusswaffensicherheit wird groß geschrieben.
Yeah, gun safety is a really big thing in the US, apparently. And Austria, they have introduced data retention, and we could really see what great police work that data retention laws enable. We can see what they were, what this was used for. A little bit of drug stuff, stalking things, so the really dangerous stuff. And in the majority of cases, this data that was collected due to the data retention laws did not even contribute to solving the cases.
Das ist ein Muster, was man häufiger sieht, auch
and this is something that we see a lot in other countries as well. We have some very interesting statistics here. For example, in the US, we have the Patriot Act that enables the police to search a house, for example, without a court order. And they have 11,000 cases per year. And out of these, 51 were related to terrorism in any way. And we have also seen that the US police is getting military gear, so these are regular policemen in the US. And we were interested in knowing that how many percent of the SWAT, whenever the SWAT team was used, how many times did they have actually a reason to do that? And it turns out that in 7% of the cases, they had a reason. But we're going to have that in Berlin as well, and in Bavaria also. We are doing predictive policing, where they kind of try to predict where to strike and where they should send the policemen, and this has been a great success apparently. In Bavaria they have an extra 3 break-ins which they have solved.
For example, the database of terror suspects, and there are 1.5 new names in the last 5 years after a very specific checking. Of course, the police is always trying to get the right middle. So there is a pizzeria in Wien, which was used for by anarchists, and that's what they went with a panzer,
a tank,
with the, and there were 1,700 police officers to get 19 people.
Das ist schon irgendwie eher stolz.
So that's wow.
Auch ansonsten kümmert sich die Polizei natürlich um wichtige Dinge, also
but police also does important things. So people try to go of the
Australian extreme swimmer crosses the English Channel and is intercepted by British police.
And there is also the Antifa sport group. And
these are anti-fascists in Dresden.
And there was this scandal.
Well,
was so way too much critic on the police, and it's only a sport group, and they never existed. That was.
And to investigate them, 900,000 records, cell phone records, were retrieved in the state of Saxony.
There was also a problem that lots of informations aren't even in German. So, well, we don't look at them because we do have to do in things in German. So if you want to do something, don't do it in German.
And this stopped an investigation of economic crimes.
They found a... the police forgot 300 grams of plastic explosive, and they found it out somehow because one passenger from a flight company lost their luggage, and the company proposed the luggage with the plastic explosive as a replacement, and we found the photo from the search canine. So there is
electronic foot tags now
for Salafists. So in the US, some police men created a Facebook site to
attract a suspect within a drugs investigation. And the girlfriend of this person was arrested, telephone seized, and on the telephone there were these half-nude pictures, and they started a Facebook profile with that to attract the actual suspect. So if you wonder how all these pictures get into the internet, here you go.
EDA. Of course, there are some people who really have problems with their conscience. There is a state trooper who, during a traffic stop, who asked the person being controlled if they accepted Jesus Christ in their heart and if they confessed. And that's what we thought about it, the televangelists.
So Sharia police in the US is what the subtitle says.
Oh, there are also there are quotes, success
quotas,
and they just went to the train station and just got some drunk cars which were at the train station and arrested them, so they get that quota. So how do you create these quotas? And one could do that with the weights and bigger cases, and there would be this one interesting case. If you
this
did,
is a figure from a German TV program, I think,
and
the bread,
the and traditional category of the Balls of Steel award.
Last one, I think, hard competition here, tough competition. What we liked a lot were the protests in the UK against the porn laws. You may remember porn in the US now can just contain the most meager of vanilla sex, and things that actually are satisfying for women are banned. And the protests were fantastic. We could have used 20 more pictures for that, but we are a bit close for time. Now, fantastic were the protests in Hong Kong. This picture above there is the best, isn't it? No, this is how apparently, supposedly, they arrest a ringleader, and it looks like Matrix, doesn't it? And also that nice banner there, they can't kill us all. In Hungary, the protests were successful, which I found very nice. This was about an internet tax that the government wanted to raise or introduce. According to volume, this was not that popular with smartphone users, as you can see here. And a very nice case of civil spiritedness, the NSA, the MPAA gave the Citizen 4 movie that we saw an R rating, which is poisonous to a movie, but some cinemas said we won't cooperate, and this center said we think this film is appropriate and essential for anyone wanting to vote, and that's why we will still screen it. Citizen 4, of course, being the movie about Edward Snowden that was screened here last night. Now, positive, what we found was this guy who actually made it his task to keep asking questions in the German government's press conference and ask questions like when would the procedure start against Cheney for his laws, and responses would be a stammering from the press people of the government. So ask and don't let go. This is what we like, and we explicitly call to other journalists to do the same. This is what's missing. And as a reward, if you do a thing like that, there's this face of the press spokesperson seeing you, the journalist, come in. This is what he looks like then. And if you don't do something like that as a journalist, it might lead to people in the street becoming a bit restless and use traditional methods of protest. Which led to the demonstration laws in Spain being restricted. We can't imagine why. And another very nice action was a member of the Ku Klux Klan who had his coming out, celebrated his coming out on Twitter. Well, not that voluntarily. So there are alternative explanations. He got into a fight in Ferguson, and there were people taking over the next Ku Klux Klan account. So the winner of this year's Balls of Steel Award, this is our two German artists that managed to get on the Brooklyn Bridge in the US and put a white flag with stars and stripes on it. We thought, well, it's not that large of an achievement, is it? But in New York, ever since the 11th of September, they are in complete terror lockdown, and the local press reacted accordingly and said, this time it was a flag, next time it could be a bomb. This bridge is guarded around the clock by security personnel, not just cameras, but there are actually people there to guard this bridge. So this is not so simple, not just to get up there, but to actually get onto the bridge as a pedestrian is not that easy. So this was quite a thing. And with that, we would all like you to wish you a Merry Crisis and a Happy New Year. Yes, and the same from us. Not the last thing you'll hear of us translators, of course, but for tonight, this is the end, and we hope you've enjoyed our translation of the Fnord News Show. We hope we were able to bring you something of the entertainment on stage and translate not just what was said, but also some background. And your translators were Sebastian and Kai.
But wait a second, there is an egg on stage.
Ein Bombenprogramm hier.
A bomb of a program.
Total awesome. Vielen Dank. Lass uns diesen
totally awesome. Thank you.
Räumen.
Let's clear this room in an orderly manner. And as you do that, remember you can give us translators feedback. We have a hashtag that we use, C3T, and there is a Twitter account called C3Translate.
Das ist wirklich leer.
The egg is empty, it's just a Fnord. So, the longest you let yourself be Fnorded,
the longer he has to stand there.